Amen. All right, we're going to turn back the clock a little bit. So this is a newish take on a pretty old hymn written by a fellow named Isaac Watts. And Isaac was a minister back in the early 1700s, wrote this, the hymn, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross in 1707. He felt like most of the songs of his day weren't getting the job done and inspiring his church to enter in. So took it upon himself to write more than 600 hymns. There were entire hymn books of Isaac Watts hymns out there. And he wrote this one for a communion service in 1707. So appropriate that we're doing it here in 2021 for a communion service. But it's interesting how, you know, I'm kind of neck deep in the whole worship music thing, and everybody's like, oh, you know, things aren't as good as the old stuff. I'm like, well, there was a lot of chaff in the old stuff that got separated as time went on. And 200-300 years, if the Lord tarries from now, there's going to be chaff that we do today that's going to get separated, and the wheat endures. This is some wheat right here. So join us as we sing with the wonderful cross, which takes its text from When I Survey the Wondrous Cross. First, I'm going to read Philippians 3, 7 to 9. But whatever things were gained to me, those things I have counted as loss for the sake of Christ. More than that, I count all things to be lost in view of the surpassing value of knowing Christ, Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and count them but rubbish, so that I may gain Christ, and may be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own derived from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness which comes from God on the basis of faith.
All Psalm 115, verse 1. Not us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give glory, because of your loving kindness, because of your truth.
Highest praise, honor, and glory be unto your name, O Lord, unto your name alone, the name of Jesus, at which every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that you are Lord. Prepare our hearts and minds as we visit your table now, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated.